Hello viewers, I am back again with my favorite subject, physics. Today my topic is refraction through a lens. When the object is placed at focus, we are getting the image at infinity. When the ray is coming parallel to the principal axis, it is converging at the focus of the lens. The whole chapter revolves around lens. So first of all, I want to define what is a lens. So lens is a transparent refracting medium bounded by two spherical surfaces or by one spherical surface and other plane surface. Now, there are two types of lenses, convex lens and concave lens. Convex lens is thick in the middle and thin at the periphery. So this is the shape of convex lens. Convex lens and concave lens is thin in the middle and thick at the periphery. So this is the shape of concave lens. Now this lens, because it is thick in the middle and thin at the periphery, it converges all the rays passing through it. So it is also known as converging lens. And concave lens diverges the rays passes through it. So it is also known as diverging lens. Now try to understand the converging and diverging action of a lens by a set of prism. For simplicity, we are taking a glass slab at the center and then two prism, one at the top and then other at the bottom. Now we know the rules. Whenever a ray passes through a prism, it will bend towards its base. Here also, whenever a ray passes through a prism, it will bend towards its base. It means it goes in the upward direction. Whenever a ray passes through a rectangular glass slab, it passes undeviated. It means all the three rays meet at a point, and this is known as the focus. And these three rays meet at this point, it means converge at this point. And this is how we can explain the converging action of a convex lens. Similarly, for a concave lens, we will assume the prism but in the inverted position, and then a glass slab, and then again a prism. Now the property remains same. Whenever a ray passes through the prism, it will bend towards its base. But this time, its bending shows the diverging ray. And second prism, again the ray diverges. And the ray which passes through center of the glass slab passes undeviated. It means all the three rays go in and opposite directions. It means diverging. And when we produce them backward, they will meet at a point. This is known as F, focus, F. It means these rays coming to appear from this point, and this is known as virtual focus of this concave lens. Let's talk about a few technical terms related to lens. So first of all, center of curvature. So we know a lens has two spherical surfaces. So this is the first circle and this is the second circle, and this is the convex lens formed. Now center of the circle here and then center of the circle here. This is C1 and this is C2. So two centers. So center of curvature is the center of the sphere whose part is the lens surface. This is the center of this sphere and this is the center of this sphere. Now second is radius of curvature. Radius of the sphere whose part is the lens surface. Radius means this much is the radius and then this much is the radius. So this is the radius. In case of a concave lens, this is the concave lens formed by again two spherical surfaces. Here also center. This is the optical center O. Here C2 and C1 on the left side. Now this is the radius. Radius of curvature, the radius of the sphere whose part is the lens surface is known as radius of curvature. Principal axis, line joining the center of curvature of two surfaces of the lens. It means C1, C2 is the principal axis. For simplicity, we will extend this line on both sides. Now, optical center, point on the principal axis of the lens such that a ray of light passing through this point emerges parallel to the direction of incidence. It means if any ray passes through the optical center of a lens, it passes undeviated. although there is a little deviation like in a glass slab, but the emerging ray is parallel to this. So for our simplicity, we just take it as undeviated. In both the lenses, this ray which is passing through optical center passes undeviated. A light ray can enter from either side of the lens. Therefore, a lens has two principal foci, one on either side of the lens. If the medium is same on both the sides, then the distance of both the focal point is same from the optical center. So first focal point for a convex lens, first focal point is the point F1 on the principal axis, F1 on the principal axis, such that the rays of light coming from it after refraction become parallel to the principal axis of the lens. It means if a ray is coming, it is becoming parallel to the principal axis after refraction. The ray is coming, it is becoming parallel to the principal axis after refraction. So this is first focal point for a convex lens. Now for a concave lens, ray of light is coming, and if it becoming parallel to the principal axis, here also it is becoming parallel to the principal axis, then these two rays meet at a point, appears to meet at a point. So this is known as the F1 point for a concave lens, first focal point for a concave lens. Now second focal point for a convex lens, F2, is the point on the principal axis of the lens, such that the rays of light incident parallel to the principal axis after refraction from the lens pass through it. It means rays are coming parallel to the principal axis and they are meeting at this point. So this is the second focal point, F2, for a convex lens. And similarly for concave lens, F2 lies on this side. For a concave lens, F2 is on this side, F1 is on right side. For a convex lens, F1 is on left side and F2 is on right side. Next definition is focal length. It is the distance of the first focal point from this optical center. This is known as first focal length, depicted as F1. And distance of this second focal point from the optical center, this is known as F2. So this is second focal length and this is first focal length. Similarly here also, this is second focal length and this is first focal length. If the medium is same on both sides of the lens, then first focal length and second focal length are same. Usually when we talk about focus, we are talking about F2. For a convex lens, this is a real focus, and for a concave lens, this is a virtual focus. Now the factors. Focal length of a lens depends on two factors: refractive index of the material of the lens with respect to its surrounding medium. It means focal length is related with refractive index and it is directly proportional. If refractive index increases, then focal length also increases. The question might come in the form, if a lens is placed in water instead of air, it is placed in water, then its focal length increases because we know refractive index increases at that point. Focal length of a lens depends on second factor, it is radii of curvature of two surfaces. It means the more thick the lens is, it has less focal length, and if it is thin, it has more focal length. It means radii of curvature, it means radii, or you can say radius, is inversely proportional to focal length. If focal length increases, then radius decreases. One more question which can be asked in this context is, if a part of lens is covered with cloth or any other thing, is there any difference with focal length of the lens? So the answer is no. Focal length remains unchanged. The only effect is on the intensity of light. The amount of light entering the lens get reduced. Otherwise, the position and the nature of the image remains unchanged. Now we are going to talk about formation of image by a lens. For this, we need to remember three principal rays in these ray diagrams. So first principal ray is, whenever a ray comes and incident on a lens passing through optical center, it passes undeviated. Same in concave also, whenever a ray comes and passes through principal axis, at the optical point it passes undeviated. So this is the main principal ray and it is very easy to draw, so always remember this ray. In each and every diagram, this ray is must. In second case, whenever a ray is coming parallel to the principal axis, after passing through the lens, it goes towards F2 of that lens. Ray parallel to the principal axis converges at F2. Or in case of concave lens, whenever a ray coming parallel to the principal axis, it appears to come from second focus, it means F2. It diverges and appears to come from this point F2. And third principal ray is whenever a ray is coming from first focal point and it passes through lens, it becomes parallel to the principal axis. Ray is coming from first focus and becoming parallel to the principal axis. In this case also, concave lens, the ray is becoming parallel to the principal axis and it appears to come from F1. Remember, here the ray is converging at second focus F2 or appears to come from second focus F2. But in this case, you need to draw the ray from F1 and then it becomes parallel to principal axis. Here also appear to come from F1. For the formation of image, you need to draw at least two of these three rays. For ray diagram, proper ray diagram, two rays are must. So either you can pass them through optical center, or first they are parallel and then passing through second focus, or you can take third ray, rays coming from focus and then becoming parallel to principal axis. But at least two rays are must. Now try to understand three significant rays with the help of this laser beam. When it is passing through the optical center of the lens, it is passing undeviated. Now, second ray, if the ray is coming parallel to the principal axis, it is converging. It means bending towards the principal axis. Now, this is our third ray. Whenever a ray is coming from first focal and it passes through lens, it becomes parallel to the principal axis. Ray is coming from first focus and becoming parallel to the principal axis. When the ray is coming parallel to the principal axis, it is converging at the focus of the lens. It means it is a converging lens. Ray is bending towards the center. Now we are going to discuss the characteristics and location of image by a convex lens. It means converging lens. So first of all, try to understand what are the possibilities where object can be placed. It means distances of the object from the lens. The first distance is when the object is at infinity. Second is when the object is beyond 2f. Third is at 2f. Fourth is in between 2f and f1. And then fifth is at f1. And sixth is in between optical center and focus. These are the six different possibilities where an object can be placed. Now we will discuss where the image is formed in all these cases differently. While constructing a ray diagram, first of all, draw a principal axis. It means a straight line. Then we need to draw the lens, then a line in between the lens, then optical center at its middle point, then second focus and first focus almost at equal distance. And then double of its distance is 2f2. For simplicity, you can take a compass and then draw an arc, and this becomes this portion of the circle, and then from second focus you can also draw an arc and then you will get this convex lens. But you can draw simply also. This, remember, this distance, if you are taking 5 cm, then this distance should be 5 cm. Only then your diagrams will be neat and clean. Now our first case is when the object is at infinity. So it means rays are coming parallel to the principal axis. So it means rays are coming parallel to the principal axis from infinity. While drawing a ray, your arrow is must. When it passes from convex lens, it is a converging lens, it passes through focus. Any ray which is coming parallel to the principal axis passes through second focus. So here we get the image. It is diminished, and in all the five cases we will get a real and inverted image. Always keep in mind this combination of real and inverted. Whenever image is real, it is inverted also. When we come to virtual, then it becomes erect, and in this case it is diminished also. Second possibility is when the object is at a farther distance, it means u is much more than f from the lens. So in this case, first ray which we need to draw is when a ray is coming and passing through f1, it is becoming parallel to the principal axis after passing through the lens. And second ray which is coming from the optical center passes undeviated. Where these two rays meet, we get the inverted image A dash B dash of the object, and this is F2, our second focal plane. This is our focal plane. So we are getting the image at this focal plane A dash B dash, and the characteristic of the image is again it is real and inverted and diminished. In this manner, a convex lens is used in a camera lens where we get the image at a focal plane. And when we get the image at a focus, then it is used as a burning glass. We place a paper at the focus of a convex lens, and when sun rays come and focus at this point, the paper starts to burn. When the object is placed at infinity, when I adjust this screen, I will see a sharp, real and inverted, and a very small diminished image of the distant object. You can see a small diminished image of this candle flame. It is inverted also. This is the focus of this lens I am using here. It is near about 20 centimeter. For better clarity, same experiment in dark mode. Now the object is at infinity and we are going to obtain its image on screen. Now you can see at this point I am getting the clear image, and it is real and inverted and highly diminished, a very small candle flame you can see also in the inverted phase. In the first case, we have seen when the object is at infinity, its image formed at focus, it means second focus, and image nature of the image is it is real, it is inverted, and at the same time highly diminished, very small. For the second case, we need to put the object beyond 2f. So beyond 2f, I am placing the object like this. We need to place an arrow, need to write A and B here. Then a ray is coming parallel to the principal axis. After passing through the lens, it is passing through F2 because it is a converging lens. And when a ray is passing from optical center, it passes undeviated. These two rays meet at this point. We get the image at this point A dash B dash in between F2 and 2F2. Image is formed in between F2 and 2F2. So the object is beyond 2F2 and image is in between F2 and 2F2. Same real inverted and here diminished. This is the second case when the object is beyond 2F. It means double the focal length, 20 plus 20, 40, and it is beyond this distance. Object is at beyond 2F. Then the image I am getting here is, I need to adjust again. Here you can see I am getting again a sharp image. It is real, it is inverted, and it is slightly diminished. In between F and 2F, this is 20, this is 40. It is in between, lying in between these two. So in between F and 2F, I am getting the image when the object is beyond 2F there. Now this is our second case. When the object is beyond 2F, it means at a far distance. Now I know the image will be obtained in between F and 2F. So here you can see real and inverted image. This is F and this is 2F. It is in between F and 2F. I am getting a sharp image. It is real, inverted, and diminished also. Now our third case is when the object is at 2F1. When the object is placed and marked as AB, the ray which is coming parallel to the principal axis passes through focus. After refraction, it passes through focus. And the ray which is coming from optical center, it passes undeviated. And you can see the image is formed at 2F2 and marked as A dash, B dash, and it is of the same size. as the object. If the object is of 3 cm, then the image is also of 3 cm. For the completion of diagram, we need to draw arrows. Now, in third case, the object is placed at 2F1. The image is formed as also 2F2, and the nature of the image is real, inverted, and of the same size. When the object is at 2F, so the image is at 2F. Now you can see this is the image of this object which is placed at 2F, and image is also forming at 2F. Image is real, image is inverted, and it is of the same size. It is of the same size as the object is in front of it. Now this is our third case, when the object is at 2F. So image will be obtained at 2F. Now adjusting the distance, you can see here I am getting an image which is sharp. It is real, it is inverted, and almost of the same size as the object. Now coming to fourth case, when the object is in between 2F1 and F1, the object is placed here as AB. The ray which is coming parallel to the principal axis passing through focus. And then the ray which is passing through optical center, it passes undeviated. And these two rays meet at this point. So our image is formed at this point as A dash and B dash, and it is beyond 2F2. So this is our fourth case, when the object is in between F1 and 2F1, the image is formed beyond 2F2, and the nature of the image, it is real, it is inverted, and it is slightly magnified. Arrows are must, so we need to place these arrows also. Now, focus on these cases, second and fourth. In second case, the object is beyond 2F2 and image is forming in between F2 and 2F2. In fourth case, the object is in between 2F1 and F1 and image is formed beyond 2F2. So, second and fourth case are just opposite to each other. You can remember these easily. Coming to fourth case, the object is in between F and 2F. So we know the image will be obtained beyond 2F. So I need to move the screen like this and you will get an image at this point. It is beyond 2F. We are getting a real and inverted image, and you can see it is magnified also. So this is our fourth case, when the object is in between F and 2F and we are getting the image which is beyond 2F. Now our fifth case is when the object is at F1. We need to place the object at F1, mark as AB. First ray which is coming parallel to the principal axis, it passes through focus. And second ray which is passing from optical center, it passes undeviated. But these two rays will not meet, and they will meet at infinity. So in fourth case, the object is placed at F1 and the image is formed at infinity, and the nature of the image, it is also real, it is also inverted, and again magnified. So now this first and fifth case are opposite to each other. In first case, we have seen the object is at infinity and the image is forming at focus. In fifth case, we have seen the object is at focus and image is forming at infinity. So first and fifth case are opposite to each other. It is very easy for you to remember like this. Now this first and fifth case. When the object is at focus, it means in my case is it 20 centimeter from the lens. Now the image is forming at infinity. You can see it is real, inverted, and highly magnified. If the image is real, inverted, and highly magnified, it means it is forming at infinity in the case of convex lens. When the object is at focus, we are getting a real and inverted highly magnified image. Can see the image is highly magnified. It is real, it is inverted and highly magnified. When the object is placed at focus, we are getting the image at infinity. Now this is our last case of convex lens, when the object is placed in between focus and optical center. The object is placed in between focus and optical center, mark as AB. Now the ray which is coming parallel to the principal axis passes through F2 after refraction, and the ray which is passing through optical center, it passes undeviated. But these two rays will not meet this side. Rather, if we extend this ray backward, then these rays will meet, but on the same side of the lens, and the rays are not actually meeting. So this is a virtual image. We need to draw this virtual image dotted and mark it as A dash, B dash. This is the case where in convex lens, we are getting an image which is of virtual nature. In all the five cases, the nature of the image, it is real and inverted. In last case, when the object is in between F1 and optical center, the image is on the same side of the lens. Same side of the lens, and it is highly magnified. It is virtual, and combination is virtual, erect, and highly magnified. Now in the last case, when the object is in between focus and optical center, we will get the image, but now the image will be virtual and erect and highly magnified, but we cannot obtain the image on the screen because it is a virtual image. When the object is in between focus and optical center, you can see we are getting no image because now the nature of the image is virtual and we cannot obtain this image on the screen. Now to sum up all these cases, we need to remember in all the five cases we are getting real and inverted image. When we are starting to place object from infinity, the size of the image is highly diminished, then it is diminished, then at 2f it becomes of the same size, then in between f and 2f, it start getting magnified, then magnified, and then highly magnified in the last case. But in the last case, with higher magnification, its nature also changes. It becomes virtual and erect. And you need to draw this virtual image as dotted. Object is as AB and image is as A dash. Now the uses of all these cases, the first case of convex lens is used in a burning glass. Second case, when the object is beyond 2f2, it is used in a camera lens. Third case, when the object is at 2f1, it is used in terrestrial telescope. Fourth case, when the object is in between f1 and 2f1, the convex lens is used in a slide projector. When the object is at f1, the convex lens is used in a collimator or spectrometer. And the last case, when the object is in between focus and optical center, it is used as a magnifying glass. Magnifying glass and burning glass, these are the two most important cases from all of these. I am sure you have understood all the topics covered till now regarding the lens. I will cover concave lens and numericals in my next video. Till then, watch my videos, share with your friends. Goodbye. Thank you.